Hi, I'm Patricia, representing Camera Publishing, and I'm here to talk to you about the dangerous liaison between the author and editor.
The first meeting between the author and editor is a crucial one, because it lets you know from the get-go the relationship and how it's gonna pan out. So here is a few types of authors you encounter. The turtleneck writer. Now, this writer just won't let go of his manuscript. From the moment he steps into your office, he seems uncomfortable, and you realize that his manuscript is actually one of his limbs, and that if you try to take it away from him, it just won't go easily. So throughout the meeting, his fingers will remain clasped at his life's work, and you start suspecting that he just doesn't want to give it to you. You try to put him at ease, but it just won't do. So you begin to think that maybe it's best if he just kept it. But then, after making you feel like a Disney villain trying to steal his lifelong love, he parts ways with his baby, with a tear in his eye and an empty heart, and you realize that the relationship with him is gonna be one emotional roller coaster. The cigar writer. Now this writer, as soon as he steps in, lets you know that every publishing house from New York to London wants a piece of him, of his manuscript, but that he, for obscure sentimental reasons, has chosen Lebanon, and even better, your publishing house. He talks to you about the importance of the written word, from Gutenberg to laser printing, in all his eagerness to show you just how much he knows about printing and books. And he warns you that he won't allow you to change not even a single comma from his book, that it should be as is, and that's non-negotiable. He will never look you straight in the eye. His eyes will wander around your office, and you will know that you're dealing with a person that's not very secure and who is overcompensating with ego. If you don't publish him, he'll tell you it's just as well because you're not good enough for him anyway. The turtleneck, no, that's the double chin writer. The double chin writer is someone who is almost apologetic about writing. He tells you that it's okay if you don't publish him. It doesn't matter. He was just passing through, and he's only doing this because of his thousands of Facebook followers and his entire family who begged him to do it. He will smile nervously at you, but don't be fooled by his false modesty, because this guy realizes his talent and the extent of it, and he will definitely make you realize just how lucky you are he stepped inside your office, him and his posse. The Kleenex writer will sit across from you with a Kleenex, very fidgety and nervous. He will tell you about his father, who is very ill and who will only be cured if this book gets published. He will beg you to not take long before you get back to him, because his whole future depends on you and this decision. As soon as he hands you his manuscript, he knows he won't sleep at night. It will take all of his willpower to not call and harass you day after day to know where you're at, when you're getting back to him. He might even lock himself in the bathroom and bowl and gnaw his teeth out until you get back to him. And you're facing a bit of a conundrum, because if you don't publish him, you'll feel guilty about it. But if you do, you will have an author in hysterics who will have 400 questions weekly and who will always need a shoulder to cry on and an ear to listen. So good luck with that. He's even annoying now. That's the do-it-yourself writer. It's the writer who takes on everything from logo design to paper choice. He contacts the printers himself. He even thinks about going to the printers and printing it himself. He thinks he knows your job better than you, and he wants to show you the way. He might even call you and tell you he already sold 300 copies of his book when you haven't even read the manuscript yourself. So that's that. And he's thankful, and he thanks you 1,000 times. He just doesn't trust you to do the work you have to do. So he does it himself. The Superman writer. Now this one, from the get-go, tells you that what he's holding in his hand is an absolute masterpiece, that it's gonna catapult your printing house right to the top, and you should just buckle up for the ride. Before even handing it to you, he talks about the sponsoring, the celebrities who back him up, the international fame he's about to embark you on. So you feel a bit small. And if you dare ask him with a very small voice what the manuscript is about, you get his very dignified smirk, and he tells you it's not even about that, man. He's gonna sell millions of copies, he's gonna be on all the covers of all the magazines ever, and you just have to be ready for it, because you are the anointed one, you are the chosen one, you are the privileged one who is gonna launch this phenomenon into the world. So he leaves with the scent of megalomania, and you have to deal with the rest. Now, this is the actual writer, the writer. Thankfully, he makes up for all the rest. He is there for you. He knows how the industry functions. He doesn't expect to get a Nobel Prize from his first novel. He doesn't expect to become a millionaire, and he's okay with that. He's happy to be corrected. He's happy to review a section of his work if you see fit. He shows up happily to book signings. He calls once a year to check on sales. He is always there, he is always humble, and he always finds the right way to say thank you. And I'm not, that's actually the result. That's a pretty happy editor you see there. So it's a rare occurrence, but it exists. Which isn't to say that us editors are godsend, far from it. But that's another presentation for another time. So thank you for yours.